it's weird. You know, people see my kids driving 1,100 horsepower car.
We're here at LS Fest West with Rick Squires, debuting our new partnership with STS Turbos and Holley Performance. Rick was kind enough to bring out his 2008 ZR7 Corvette that just happens to sport twin rear-mounted turbos. Rick, I've seen him around the industry for years, but I have to ask you, why rear-mounted turbos?
You know, that is a big question that we get. First, if you've ever seen under the hood of a Corvette, where are you going to put them?
It's right? A little cramped, isn't it?
You know, everything's made of plastic, and you put a couple of turbos the size of basketballs that are going to turn bright yellow and catch on everything on fire. You know?
You'll be oozing plastic.
You know, so the installation process is so much easier when we put them where there's room. The turbo is actually a great muffler, and so we can take the mufflers off and replace the turbo, you know, in the spot where the muffler is, and it makes the car sound amazing, and there's our real estate where we put it in, so awesome. We don't have to cut and chop and do those things that some of the other companies have to do.
I'm sure there's some other benefits too, being they're not in a hot engine bay. They're getting extra air back there probably.
Oh yeah, the turbo's on vacation, right? It's used to running at, you know, over 2,000 degrees and turning bright yellow,
right,
and coking the oil when you shut off. So you have to have turbo timers and all those things. Our turbos, they look the same, you know, on the dyno pole as they do sitting in the box. They just don't even change colors. They run at a lot lower temperature.
So that's definitely a benefit. A lot lower temperatures, probably a lot cooler in their air intake charge as well.
Yeah, all the heat soak capability of a front mount system where you've got all that tubing packed in there with the turbos, everything under the hood, it just, everything gets hotter and hot. And so you've got to have this massive intercooler to try and get that temperature down, where we've got, you know, the turbos in the back, so the temperature coming out is cooler to start with. And then as they go through the tubing up to the front, it's what we call passive intercooling, where we shed a lot of that real hot heat out on the way to the intercooler.
Oh, makes sense.
So then we run at a lot cooler temperature into the intercooler, so our temperatures coming out of the intercooler are really close to ambient, actually.
Really?
Yeah, so the horsepower fan
awesome.
Boost is huge.
Rick, I'm sure you get this question a lot, but the turbos are all the way in the back of the car, the intake's all the way in the front.
I know what you're gonna say.
Turbo lag.
Yep, turbo lag. You know, and we get that question all the time. People see the visible length and go, wow, how long does it take to get that air all the way up there? And, you know, if you think about the exhaust coming out of the engine, how long does it take before it leaves that exhaust valve till it goes out the tailpipe at wide open throttle?
Not very long.
It's that fast. And so it's really not an issue of length.
Okay.
I mean, even you look at like a Pro Mod car, you know, the size of tubing on a Pro Mod car is 5-6 inches, and it runs from the turbo up at the grill clear into the back of the car where they've got a huge water air intercooler. It's like a 55 gallon drum, right?
And it has to go
and
all,
then
all the
way back up. And you know, how long does it take those to come on boost?
It's not very long.
It's less than 6 seconds because they're over 200 miles at that point, right?
That's right.
So you know, it's more of a turbo sizing issue.
Okay.
You know, you can have turbo lag on a conventional front mount system too. You put too much turbo on there,
right,
you're gonna have lag. And so the
matching
bigger the
components.
Turbo, yeah, it's matching components.
Okay.
So the engineering that we do,
that makes sense,
is with our customers, is we help them so they don't have to try and figure out which turbo is going to work.
You've done the engineering and the R&D work.
We've done all that for them. And if they have a special application, we help with that.
Okay.
So we know how our systems work, and we're engineering it.
That's great.
So that they perform awesome.
That's great. Because there's a lot of voodoo out there with turbos,
yeah.
You know.
Yep. Well, and it's turbos. There's a little voodoo in turbos anyway.
Right.
A lot of people don't understand how they work.
So, Rick, this system is essentially the same system that's under the Corvette?
Yeah, this is the exact same system on my car.
What kind of horsepower potentials can I expect?
Well, it depends on how much boost you want to run. And that's the cool thing about a turbo is you've got that option to have multiple boost stages.
How are we controlling that? Are we using a special tuner? Or?
We just have a boost controller, and it just regulates the wastegate to say, all right, we want 5 pounds of boost, or we want 7, or we want 10, or in the case of my car, we want 18.
Okay. Right?
And you can flip a switch and on the fly and change between boost levels.
Really?
So super cool.
What kind of horsepower potential do we have? You know, are we talking 50 to 500?
You know, most of our systems at 5 pounds of boost are going to be somewhere in that 100 to 150 horsepower gain range, depending upon the size of the engine.
Mm-hmm.
But as you start turning the boost up, and this system right here with these turbos is capable of, the base turbos that come with the kit, 760 horsepower at the crank.
Wow.
And nice small turbos, super responsive.
Spools fast.
No nitrous. Yeah, you can put nitrous on if you want to. So, but yeah, it's you've got about a 5 pound kit that's going to be stock.
Okay.
You're getting about 150 horsepower with that.
And you can do that on a stock engine.
Awesome. Yeah. These LS motors are awesome. They are just built for boost.
They
can handle up to about 10 pounds of boost really pretty safely.
Without any modifications.
And 10 pounds of boost on one of these Corvettes, you are, you know, 750, kind of 760 horsepower, which is the limit
That's
of this
respectable.
Turbo.
That's pretty respectable.
You know, and then you upgrade the turbos. So the turbos on my car, we usually run, you know, we got a 1,000 horsepower set, and I run those on the street a lot because they're still super responsive.
Really?
It's super fun to drive. But if I got to go big, I put the 1250 horse turbos on, and she's 1130
Light
horsepower. Daily driver, 30 miles a gallon, passes emissions test. It is so win-win. All our kits are, like I say, they are air filtered and tailpipe tip. And we have them in a tuner kit, which is, you know, I'm going to do my own tuning and fuel system stuff. Or we can have it as a complete kit, which comes with flow mash injectors and our Diablo Sport i3 tuner with the tune that's already on there.
You just pre-programmed?
Plug it in, push the button, says STS bass tune, click that.
It doesn't get any easier.
It loads it on and you fire it up and you drive it down the road.
Rick, we went over a couple of the applications earlier, but with this new joint partnership, what all can we get through Holley and STS right now?
You know, this partnership has been awesome. Holley has such amazing fabrication capabilities that we're changing all of our kits over. Everything is all full stainless now. And so the manufacturing process is a little different. So we don't have all of our kits available yet.
Okay.
Initially right now we have the C6 Corvettes, which are, you know, all forms of those C6 Corvettes pretty much. And then the C5 Corvettes as well.
Mm-hmm.
And the fifth gen Camaros is coming right behind with the V8s and the V6. We have a killer V6 application. I just finished one up, over 400 of the tires. Oh, they're awesome out of a V6.
That'll be happy.
Yeah. And we've got our universal kits.
Obviously.
So we've got single kits, which are available right now. And we've also got our twin kits. And so you can, I mean, anything you can imagine you want to do, we've had people do everything from airplanes to you know, farm pumps, you know, that pump water.
Right.
I mean, just anything we've had.
What if I don't own? What if I don't own a Chevy?
You know, that doesn't matter. We've had stuff overseas where we do turbos on cars I've never even heard of before. It's amazing. They just give us the information on, you know, the engine size of what they're doing, and we size the turbos for them. We send them a universal kit. All they got to do is plumb it.
So
they got to run some pipes, and they got a turbo on their car.
Cool.
So we got singles and twins there. And then right behind it, we've got all the Hemi stuff. So for all those late model Hemi guys, so all of the 5.7s, the 6.1s, the 6.4s, we got singles and twins. We've got a great package for all the Hemi guys.
Something for the Ford guys too?
Yeah, we got Ford stuff coming after that. So,
all right.
So yeah, we're systematically getting all of our kits out and back into the market with the Holley standard of products and the branding. It's going to be awesome.
Well, Rick, we're super excited for this new partnership with STS Turbos.
You know, the turbo market is so hot right now. Everybody wants turbos, and
for the exact reasons you just gave me.
Exactly. And this partnership with Holley and STS, it is a match made in heaven. And I'm excited to be part of the Holley family.
Well, thank you, Rick, and welcome to the family.
Thanks.